Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about immediate invoking functional expression. This is also known as the IFE, and you might have seen this code at many places, specifically while writing the module pattern or writing like this. So IFE, immediately invoke a functional expression. So what do you mean by this? If you talk about the syntax, this is how it looked like. This is a self-invoking expression, okay, and you can write any set of code inside. So it's like a wrapper you are creating, and this block is self-executing. You can see this is the function and the argument, and this is the calling. This is where we are calling the function directly. So it protects against polluting the global environment, because it is like a wall of China, and inside that you are writing the code. It is also retaining the privacy of the variable defined within the function. All these things are there. So if we talk about simple example, this is how it looks like. We have a function body, and inside this you can write your code. Okay, so here we can write a function, you can write some kind of a module code, and here we are passing the global window object, so I can access the window object inside this body. And here I'm just creating the person object and putting the person object in the window object. Okay, it is not same as like you are doing here. Here we are creating the functions and then calling it outside, right? So IFE block has its own numerous advantages. Can be used to avoid variable hoisting within the blocks, and while writing the asynchronous loop, we can wrap the synchronous code block inside a IFE block. That this code you might have seen many times, like you are writing a simple for loop. Let I 0, I is less than, let's 5. Let's use var keyword for now, just to understand this. And inside this we are using set timeout. Okay, inside this we are doing something like console.log or something. And here we are putting 1000 milliseconds, and we are doing console.log I here. So in this particular case, we are going to get the value 5 times, right? So how to avoid this? Because this is a synchronous context, value will reach to the 5 and set timeout has not been resolved. So the final value of I which we will receive is 5. Okay, how we can resolve it is we can wrap this inside a IFE block. Okay, so IFE block which we have just seen, it's nothing but a function. Okay, inside that we can just wrap this set timeout, and we can pass the value of I from here. So now this particular block is bound to this context, and it is able to receive the value of I. Why it is complaining? And here you can also multiply this with I if you want. So console.log I. So for every iteration the value will be passed here. And this is a asynchronous block, but this is inside a IFE block. So each and every value of I will be persisted inside it, and value will be passed. This is fine. So this you can fix it by just using let, or in that case you don't need this IFE block, because let has a block level scoping. Okay, if you are using the var, then it can be useful while you are writing asynchronous code using some loop and executing lot of promises inside it, and you want it to persist a value whatever is coming from the loop, then you can just put a IFE block, and here I'm passing the value I, so I'm able to access the value of I inside it. Okay, the prominent use of IFE block is in these cases. Okay. Thanks everyone.